65 days. I have sat up here for almost all those days, with the exception of my off days. And we have done nothing but gossip. But not just gossip. We have set people on different career paths. We have, you know, opened up parents' eyes at some point. We have taught slay queens, belittled them, called them everything under the sun. We have done a lot for 365 days. Now, on this year, last day of 2019, I know I had promised to do an entire two-hour wrap-up, but I sat down and I said, wrap up what? We're just looping into a new year, just because we know we're looping into it. But half of all the celebrities we talked about last year may make a comeback next year, and then it's just like one long train. But still, 2019 brought so many stories. So below, I'm going to list all the stories that pretty much I had fun with. They were so interesting. Other than that, welcome to the last episode of Scoop and Scoop in 2019. 2020. Hey, Jesus, welcome. So I'm looking at my tiny little paper here that, you know, we sat down and we just tried to outline all the stories. I can't do them in chronological order because they were quite hilarious. And I talked to my my YouTube guy, my social media handler, who actually pretty much runs YouTube that you guys really watch. And I asked him to give me the stories according to the YouTube algorithm that had the most views, had the most number of people watch in the shortest time possible. And you cannot believe how shocked I was. The very first story at number one, according to YouTube statistics, numbers and all, is a story I ran in January about Bad Black saying he wanted Rema to touch his body. I was like, Vida Uganda! Like, there was so much juicy stuff this year. It went political. We went through the whole Arua. When was Arua? It was this year. Dang, this year felt long. We went through the political changes. We went through Bobby Wine. We went through People Power. We went through NRM. We went through a lot this year, whereby the industry merged. You know, two places merged. Music and entertainment merged together with politicking. That happened this year. But of all the stories, according to YouTube, that is the one. That is the one. Now, let me give a few of the stories that I actually liked this year. Of course, y'all watched me do that grenade episode. Whoa, whoa! Every time I think about that story, the day it hit my desk, I was like, oh, Jesus, this is so good. Grenade wanted. But this year, in more ways than the other, I should say, Grenade, umwaka gwamtambulira bulungi Josephine, sicho. Yakuba kaimba kenkuloga, we fell in love. Nagenda na uba bulichiramu, under the sun, kastochambaza sika. Kastochambaza. Atiitamu, apparently. That story for me was everything. And then when I moved from the whole Grenade story, before I can even jump to the fact that there's a story that involves him and Sheila Gashumba, let's not forget Sheila Gashumba made our year from the beginning of the year when she thought everybody in this here country is jealous of her generational curve type of relationship with Marcus. And this same year, God's plan happened to us. Didn't he happen this year? Or he happened the other year first? A lot happened this year. Anyway, so Grenade for me was up there. Then Sheila Gashumba and all her theatrics. Linda, Josephine. Tata wa Sheila te ya mwaka. This year, Frank Gashumba tried to parent to Yakuba Mwanawe Migo. That was also fun. In that light, that was fun. Tutu ogeda kukatiba akuba. Wininwaji. Yakubo mukoz wa chupa ya mukuba namjanja na mujanja. But that all happened this year. I think those are certain things that got me, you know, moving in the industry. Because given there was not that much going on this year, but when it happened with so much intensity. Still talking about that. I'm going to basuli da we musanza to yogereko, because I know these episodes are episodes you can go back to. Then came the time of Fresh Daddy, Fresh Kiddy, Fresh Mama Wakidi. Oh God! That was that time. Now that's the time Scoop and Scoop had moved to being live. I was shooting it with Tumo and all of y'all were catcalling. Nah. But I would like to tell y'all that whole story, Fresh Kid and Fresh Daddy and all of that, as much as it arced anger and pain in me, it was one of them stories that you just couldn't help but talk about. You know, you couldn't help but give your own analysis of it. Where are they right now? Well, last time I checked, I saw Fresh Daddy's Kasalunde and Vukoto. It is not making money, ladies and gentlemen. Obama fundraising. It is not, I repeat, it is not making a nickel. Fresh Kid, on the other hand, blossoming. He got the scholarships. He's got, you know, he performed well in class this year. I mean, things are going for him. His mom on the other end, Tetumanyo Baliwa, Kubaya Zikira. Then we kept hearing stories about Fresh Kid and his management and his father. But that happened because as a nation, it trended. You guys made it possible on every social media platform. When he released that song, Ebizike, y'all cuckoo heads lost it. Some of you are actually Team Fresh Kid. No, Team Fresh Daddy. All of you were having this nonsense in your minds. I am let the guy blossom into what? Well, he never blossomed. It came and it went as it came. Just like that. Aha! What else can I remember? Let me see. Oh, yeah. Then we had SK Mbuga going to jail. Not that we didn't see it coming, but it happened so quick. We were caught off guard. Caught off guard! Then at the same time, to Anu Mlalawa, Josephine Gwebasiba, Kanakasa Jakibakwa Tamum. Nakoka Fede, Don Nasa. Apparently, all the rich people tested jail time. Then we had, was it Eddie Chayune? Was it Chayune? There was another Nalongo saga. I remember talking about it. About Mzungu Gwebakuba, Nebaba Kumiawa, Nonga Kaduka. Then they all started telling on each other. Yes, Nekuna Mwaka Banaye, Abafere Bafebageza, Kokubasiba. But they are among us. They are with us. What are they doing with their lives? SK is back, found out. Some Kayang young boy was covering his wife, but still going strong. He wants to open up a TV station. Yay! Good for him. This year, too, brought to our attention Full Figure. I know she was the Bukede Streets type of celebrity, but she crossed over when she called me personally. I'll never forget that episode. I did it with so much passion, so much fire, so much vava voom. How could I not list it among my best stories and episodes of the year? Yes, the Full Figure episode was fire for me. It was fire because it was beautiful. And then of course she stuck with us after that. She became a presidential advisor. She's doing all this nonsense. But it was pretty much higher. She stayed in the news constantly this year, just like pretty much all the people we're talking about. Then this same year, who wants to forget Omuntu Wawansi Owa Martha? Not the same Martha. Martha K. Her nudes dropped this year. Woo, child! I was sympathizing, as sympathetic to a point. But that happened this year too. This year so many nudes dropped, but I think only Martha K's nudes made the rounds because, che, y'all had something to say. Bad Black had a lot to say. This year, I would like to also say, Bad Black, comes. This year you managed to stay extremely relevant from just being yourself. The masses love you. They don't just look at you, ngamalaya. Good thing. I like that we have managed to help her turn her life around in certain ways by her being that open on social, regardless of the fact that she is too open. Ugh. Sometimes I watch her Snapchats and I'm like, yee. Okay. Then, we had Vinka this year. She was the star of the year. She was signed to music company. That's Sony. And then Irene Intale were asking, where are you? What are you doing? Irene Intale is also signed to something else. It was a good year for Vinka. It was. Shiba, on the other hand. Yeah, she did music this year, but... It wasn't like the other year, which was higher than the other year, but she was around. The only thing I remember how much for this year is that whole beef she had going on with Cindy. I honestly decided I didn't talk about that. I couldn't even. But she had this beef going on with Cindy, which inspired Cindy's... what's that name of that rhythm? The song she did. Anyway, that one. That happened to Brian White. Ah! He came back this year after disappearing for a minute. When he came back, he tried so hard to show us he still got money. Before we knew it, they were incarcerating him. Before we knew it, this is happening. He broke again. He made rounds too. He honestly did. Bujingo and Suzani happened this year. That should actually be the crown. No. Between Bujingo and Raymond, Eddie Kenzo and Oligai Mlala. Who do you think should take the year? Because Bujingo's drama lasted for long. But then as I was still dealing with Bujingo's drama, let's not forget our former VP, Mahogany himself. And his wife, and saying he's leaving his wife and his... Bujingo happened this year. Our VP and all his dirty secrets being put out by his wife also happened this year. Those for me are stories that, you know, got me thinking. They got me thinking about so many things. This same year, Remnants and Prophet Mbonye's people decided to be vocal enough to begin threatening us in the name of the Lord. Yes, this year is when they were too assertive. They're every actually this year, Buri Mulokole Church esinze na baby vul. Nakuzi nika Twitter kumoto kamifacho uli raba iti debivulu tuli raba ita night session, zi prayer sessions, guno mwaka na gogo badegwa mwebalokole mwebale muziko ze musente ndiga zino mupuvye tusimye nyo mugene mugulebi banja bya mataka muzimbira abakazi ba mwabo kusaidi na abo munda. Mchoket. Tuve wao. This year so Zahara Toto apparently fall in financial love. Yeah, it was all a plan, but anyway, we had a minute with that. We talked about that, made sense for a minute to talk about it. Then we realized, trick is so irrelevant. Why bother? MC Cats, do I need to say anything? When now I call your story, when names the next year. Apparently, at his recent Kavula Kawe Day, he said he's going to marry Fee. Wow. Moving forward, they deserve each other, Besana. And this year, for all of you who didn't know, because I couldn't bring for you the story exclusively because, well, they pretty much did not let anyone have any media in it. Did you know that the Princess of Toro, yes, Ruth Komuntale Nsemere, Liz, got married over the weekend? Yeah, this weekend. She did. In silence. No butala. This is what I was telling you people. Don't show us. We won't talk. Don't tell us. We won't talk at indiwano nange sina cha kuogera. All I know, the wedding could have been at one of them. Is it Chaninga? It was a beautiful intimate ceremony. It was beautiful. That happened. Who else got married? Gareth is not yet married. No, Josephine, we are talking about royal blood. You're in studio with me. Are you royalty? Yes, you're royalty. LOL. Gareth Onyango popped the question to the king's daughter, a princess. We are waiting for Nevi Vinavam Kolonda, but that in a way is a royal wedding. Which other royalty got married this year? There was not that much going on. Not much. Anyway, this same year is when we had Stella Nyanzi get incarcerated for saying some pretty darned words. She's still incarcerated. That happened too. This year, let me see, John Black actually owned this year, musically speaking. It was a good year for him. Mubirala sija kuogera tujatandikira wo next year because ebya John Black anamwambimanyisobola bitotola. And this same year, Stella Nantumbwe took time out. How had I forgotten this story? Stella Nantumbwe this year took time out to write in almost every publication that was around Uganda, telling us if we use her name or do what or say what, she will sue us. It was also the same time that Bettina also said something that stupid. All the slay cows finally found their heads and understood we are stupid, but our lawyers are not. This year, only this year. This year, yo man, Nyege Nyege was on this year. We all know what happened down in Nyege Nyege. Jesus is the Lord. Because analysts mpamvu. A lot went down this year. Rema and Kenzo, you know, we're still talking about them. I mean, so if you ask me what stories would I crown numero uno for me this year? I love each and every one of the stories I run this year. I do. Even the ones I run with a very, very biased mind. Even the ones that I run feeling so low. I love every story that I do. So, from me to you, it's been a blissful, blissful 2019. We're going to do this again next year. We just hope and pray that the scandals are juicier, that the receipts are clearer, that the snitches are true snitches, that all your loyal friends who surround these people forget all about royalty and loyalty. Those are my prayers for next year in regards to Scoop. I really, really want to Scoop. Yeah. So, with that all put into perspective, mwebale, tuwevumye, tusese, denzije kechi uvalo ne mungamba, msima nyo, mwebale kusasulo msala. And I keep telling people this and they don't understand. All your views pay my salary. So it's, I can't wait to do this again next year. I honestly can't. And on my social media platforms, someone asked me yesterday, T, why do you give us all these social media platforms? You're not even that very much active on them. You know why I give them to you? They're not for me. I am not like all these other slay queens who just want the followers. The social media platforms are for you to reach out to me at any given time. Depends what you're saying. That's why I give them to you. So, wrapping up 2019. It's been fun. It's been all these things. I'll catch you on the flip side, which is tomorrow. At TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and at TinaFierce1. Don't forget on Instagram, at TinaFierce1. And on Snapchat, TinaFierce1. Don't drink and drive. Njagala mwe nanyingire na mwe mumwa. Katula bebe tugendo kuono na antifokule meredi watuono na. I can't say I love you guys enough. It's been a beautiful year. Let's do this again tomorrow in 2020. I'm out. Happy New Year, folks. Peace.